Again, I used with a kind of a mold. So, and I just wanted to show you the top part, how I made that part look so colored and mixed. It's pretty easy. And again, with the bottom, I used a mold. So we'll be using this mold mainly to do all the three parts. In the first mold, you will pick what kind of color you want for the cupcake, just as a base. So you can have any kind of base that you want. I'm gonna pick a yellow. You can make it like chocolatey. So I kind of want to do that right now. I'm gonna pick this one here. I'm gonna add a little bit of white to it because it's a little bit too much. Mix that, and in the top part we can use like a purple, or what should we use? I'm gonna use this mixed with pink. This was my earlier mixed color, and in the pink that I'm gonna use, it's gonna be this hot pink. So just gonna mix it together, and I'll show you how to do the top. Now we're gonna make sure that we have enough yellow for the base. You don't have to go all the way up either. You can use as much yellow for the base that you want. I'm gonna use a little bit more. Okay, and it's ready to push in. Just keep pushing it. And it's okay if he has a dent in there inside. Just want to make sure that it goes all the way around. So you can just keep turning. And now I'm just gonna take it out. Like that, slowly and carefully, and that's the base. Okay, now that we got that, we're gonna be making this part here, which is the chocolatey part. And I'm gonna use a bit of this brown and a bit of this white to mix. Right now, once you got your chocolatey consistency, see the two white and dark chocolate made this one here. Now that I have this, I'm ready to squish it in into the next mold here. This is going to be the breading part. Just kind of hard to squish it down. Just make sure you push it in from the edges like that. Now that I got that, I'm going to let it come up on its own. So just give it a slightly there. And around the edges, you can see it looks kind of like as if it just came out of the oven. It has just those little dots. They're easy to make even with the with toothbrush. Just give it another pat to make sure they're all the same all around. You can see the texture of it starts coming together. There you go. It's a good texture, right? Now when we're gonna make the center here, that little, I think I'm gonna use this much and just roll it out. Okay, once you roll it out, you have these two here, and then you're gonna start doing this. Just twist them all up, roll them all out again. Now you have this, and now I'm gonna roll it on its own wherever it wants to go. Just twist it like that. I'm gonna press it. Basically, if you're happy with this, you can already squish it and have your mix. But I kind of want to roll it out one more time. Once you have it kind of like this, I'm going to just twist it. And I'm just twisting it just like that. Now it's ready to go in here. I'm just going to twist it up a bit. Like that. Press it all together first. See? And make a little bit of a cone shape so you can reach the very end. Especially if you have one of those deep molds. And now you're just gonna press it in. Press it in on all sides. Very good. Just like that. If there's too much clay, that's okay. We can take some away if needed. just like that. See, I'm just gonna press down and I made it like this. Keep pressing it in, and I think it's ready for my little cupcake. Just press on these and open it up, and voila. Do you see that? It's all mixed up. Hopefully the color focuses very good. So now I can put it on top of here. And just don't press on it or anything. It'll be fine. Just put the eye pin through. Give it a little pat. And there you go. A very yummy looking cupcake. I hope you can see it very well. That looks really good. And I usually just put the eye pin kind of at the end here somewhere, not directly in the center. And there you go.